गुड आफ्टरनून माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर दीपक मोरे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश संजीवनी महाविद्यालय चापोली। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट पोएम नेम्ड अ पॉइजन ट्री रिटन बाय विलियम ब्लेक। देन बैकग्राउंड ऑफ द पोएट विलियम ब्लेक, ही वॉज बॉर्न इन 1757 and he was dead in 1827. He is regarded as the most original of the English romantic poets. Unfortunately, he was mostly neglected and was even thought of as a mad person in his times. He was an engraver, artist, poet and visionary man. He wrote wonderful lyrics in his collections entitled Songs of Innocence and Songs of Experience. It was published in 1794. He also painted scenes from the works of John Milton, Dante, William Shakespeare and the Bible. His works classed as prophetic books, such as Visions of the Daughters of Albion. It was written in 1793. The First Book of Urizen. It was written in 1794. Milton, written in 1810, and Jerusalem, written in 1812, are deeply philosophical, difficult, and long series of poems. He engraved, colored, printed, stitched, and sold these works with the help of his wife named Catherine. Some of his highly appreciated poems are The Lamb, The Tiger, and London. The Jerusalem lyric from Milton is also very popular. It has become a kind of second national anthem in Britain. Blake has become one of the most favorite poets in academic circles in the modern times. His Songs of Experience contain poems that appeal to modern readers and scholars because he takes a radical stand in questioning some of the schemes of God. In Marathi, William Blake, ki jancha janma ha 1757 madhe jhala आणि यांचा मृत्यू 1827 मध्ये झाला, यांना इंग्रजीतील रोमॅन्टिक कवितेतील मूळ कवी म्हणून ओळखले जाते, परंतु दुर्दैवीपणे तो दुर्लक्षित राहिला आणि त्या काळातील मूर्ख व्यक्ती म्हणून ओळखला जाऊ लागला। तो एक शिल्पकार, कलाकार, कवी आणि ध्येयवादी व्यक्ती होता। त्याने सॉंग्स ऑफ इनोशन्स आणि सॉंग्स ऑफ एक्सपिरियन्स या नावाचे उत्कृष्ट काव्यसंग्रह 1794 मध्ये प्रसिद्ध केले। त्याने जॉन मिल्टन, दांत, विलियम शेक्सपियर आणि बायबल मधील दृश्याचे चित्रीकरण केलेले आहे। त्याचे द डॉटर्स ऑफ अलबियन, जे की 1793 मध्ये लिहिली गेली, प्रकाशित केली गेली। द फर्स्ट बुक ऑफ युरिझन, जे की 1794 मध्ये लिहिले गेले। मिल्टन नावाचा ग्रंथ 1810 मध्ये प्रकाशित केला गेला। अँड जेरुसलेम 1812 मधील अशी तात्विक विचारांची कठीण आणि लांबलचक कवितांची मालिका प्रसिद्ध केली। आधुनिक काळातील शैक्षणिक वर्तुळात ब्लेक अतिशय आवडता कवी बनला होता। त्याचे सॉंग्स ऑफ एक्सपिरियन्स हा काव्यसंग्रह आधुनिक वाचक आणि विद्यार्थ्यांना आवाहन करतो, कारण त्यांनी अत्यंत पुरोगामी विचार मांडले असून दैवी रचनेवर काही प्रश्नही विचारले आहेत। Then, introduction of the poem. The Poison Tree is a song-like poem taken from William Blake's Songs of Innocence and of Experience. It was written in 1794. Then, it is a collection in which he compared two worlds of human understanding, that is, the world of purity and the world of virtue, that is innocence, against the world of vice and corruption, that is experience. The part Songs of Experience has 26 poems, including a poison tree. This part is an expression of great regarding the ways in which the tough experiences of adult life destroy the innocence of the earlier phase or the growing up years in the human life. As the poem has musically of a song, and it has often been set to music by renowned music composer like Ralph Williams. The poem recounts a very common emotional reaction, that is anger, about which the speaker narrates. It is a poem written in simple language, but it has emotional content. The theme of the poem is familiar to common readers. The simplicity of the poem and the familiarity of its emotional content have made it one of the best loved English poems. Then, the text of the poem. The text of the poem, A Poison Tree, written by William Blake. This is a short poem having four small stanzas. Each stanza contains small four lines. In the first stanza of the poem, the poet tells us that I was angry with my friend. I am reading the text. Look at the picture, look at the PPT or slide, and listen carefully. I was angry with my friend. I told my wrath. Wrath means anger. I told my wrath. My wrath did end. I was angry with my foe. Foe means enemy. I was angry with my foe. I told it not. My wrath did go. In the first stanza of the poem, the poet addresses to the audience that this poem is in first person narrated by the poet. The poet is expressing his anger and hatred towards his enemy. The poet has used a metaphoric style. For instance, apple depicts his vengeance, tree depicts his loss of patience, and underneath which he kills his enemy. In the first stanza of the poem, the poet is not only expressing his anger towards his friend as well as his foe, but he has also depicted the difference between two types of anger. When he was angry with his friend, he simply told his friend about his anger. This action of telling had a positive effect. It put an end to his bad feelings. The action states that when you are angry with a friend, you convince your hurt to forgive him, even though you are hurt and know that he did injustice to you. You try your best to forget the past and end the feelings of vengeance in your heart. On the other hand, when he was angry with his enemy, that time he didn't tell about his anger to his enemy. Hence, the feeling of anger developed more. It states that when you are angry with an enemy, it takes ages for you to calm your anger. Yet, the anger and the feeling of vengeance do not diminish even with time. In fact, the vengeance simply grows again and again. In the second stanza of the poem, the poet tells us that and I watered it in fears. Watered means cultivate by giving water. Night and morning with my tears, and I sunned. Sunned means to give sunlight. And I sunned it with smiles and with soft, deceitful wiles. Deceitful wiles, it is a phrasal word, means keeping the truth hidden from enemy tricks. Keeping the truth hidden from the enemy tricks. Means in the second stanza, the speaker refers to the title of the poem and uses the metaphor of the tree. The poet is making a confusion that it is he who is solely responsible for the hatred that has grown in his heart for his enemy. It is he who has increased the vengeance in his heart. He has nurtured the hatred with his fears, spending hours together crying for the ill that has been caused to him by his enemy. He uses the metaphor of tree. This tree is nurtured by the feeling of fear and resentment. While these feelings were inside the poet's mind, he covered them with false smiles. This acted like sunlight for the growth of the poison tree, that is, soft, deceitful wiles that are the tricks to hide his real hatred. Thus, the anger continued to grow and it became more dangerous. Now the speaker felt the need for revenge. In the third stanza of the poem, the poet addresses that, and it grew both day and night, and it grew both day and night till it bore an apple bright. Bore, B-O-R-E, bore means result into fruit. And my foe beheld it shine. Beheld means saw. And my foe beheld it shine, and he knew that it was mine. In the third stanza of the poem, the poet tells us that the tree grew and produced a fruit. In the third stanza, the poet states that it is because of his dwelling in the same hatred that it has grown every day. The hatred gave birth to an apple. The fruit signifies the evil that has taken birth in the heart of the poet. He states that he has now come to a point from where he can't turn back and forget about his enemy until he does something to soothe his vengeance. Finally, the day comes when the poet's enemy has met the evil fruit of vengeance that he has grown with his fears, tears, and sarcasm. This bright apple attracted the enemy's attention. He knew that the fruit belonged to the poet. The fruit has now turned into a weapon. When the enemy confronts with this anger, it is time for the weapon to serve the purpose that it has been made for. In the last stanza of the poem, the poet tells us that, and into my garden stole when the night had veiled. Veiled the pole is a fragile word, means covered the pole star. In the morning glad I see my foe outstretched beneath the tree. Outstretched means lying down. These are the concluding lines of the poem. In the last stanza or fourth stanza of the poem, the poet describes how one night the enemy snaked into the poet's garden and ate the apple from this tree. This was the fruit of the poison tree. So, when the enemy ate it, he died. When the poet wakes up in the morning and glimpses in the garden, he sees something that relaxes his mind and calms his vengeance forever. There he is, his enemy dead under the tree of his hatred. Thus, the association of this poison tree is with the idea that when a person cultivates anger and hatred towards someone, these feelings can turn into something dangerous and they may result in the destruction of the enemy. At the same time, the poem suggested that these are not healthy feelings. They should not be kept in mind. If they grow, then one also starts to hate oneself. In this poem, the poet was forced to hide his anger. He therefore acted in a dishonest and false way. It killed his enemy, and he says that it made him glad. But the readers know that this is not the real happiness. Actually, the speaker has started to hate himself. The poison tree that was grown by him has a negative effect on himself also. From a good person, he has become a dishonest and deceptive person. In the concluding lines, the poem tries to explore the shameful effects of anger. The cultivation of anger is the principal theme of the poem. It tells about how the suppression of anger leads to the growth of anger and other destructive feelings. When we do not express anger and acknowledge it, anger or wrath is cultivated by the mind. It becomes a destructive force. The poem compares suppression versus expression, and also speaks about falseness in the human nature. We can interpret the poem as a title telling about the people who pretend to be friendly, but they may be hiding their real feelings. Thus, the poem also suggests that all persons can be guilty of suppressing their inner emotions, and this can become deadly to the outside world. Thank you. Thank you very much.